What's up, guys? Welcome back. Today is an exciting day because today is the day we get to test out our nitro cotton. Now, in yesterday's video, we took some extremely dangerous acids and used them to turn ordinary cotton balls into nitro cotton. And what exactly is nitro cotton? Well, you're about to find out. Now, these here are the cotton balls that we worked with yesterday, and I've let them sit overnight, so they're about as dry as we can get them. Which is good, because I don't think nitro cotton works very well if it's wet. And now, if we compare them to one of our original cotton balls, you can see they're a little bit smaller, and they've taken on kind of a yellowish tinge. Other than that, it just feels like a cotton ball that got a little bit too wet and then dried out overnight. Now, you remember yesterday we weighed each of our cotton balls individually, and I'm curious to know today, now that they've been nitrated, if there's any difference in weight. All right, let's start with cotton ball number one. This was 0.55 grams originally, and now we're showing 0.80 grams. It's kind of like fluctuating, 0.80, 0.85. I wonder if that's because there's still a little bit of moisture in it, or if it's actually changed weight. Okay, so I just reweighed all of the cotton balls here, and it seems that in almost every case, the cotton ball weighs about 0.3 grams more than it did yesterday. And I'm not sure if that's still because there's a little bit of moisture in here that's waiting to evaporate off, or if the physical properties of the cotton ball itself has changed, but in almost every case, the cotton ball has increased in weight by 0.3 grams. Interesting. Now this is the fun part, the moment we've all been waiting for, because now we get to burn it. Now before we start burning our nitro cotton, let's start off burning one regular cotton ball just so we have a standard to measure it against. Now to light this thing off, we could just use the flame from a barbecue igniter, but that's a little bit too easy. So to switch things up a little bit, let's try using some sparks from a ferrocerium rod and a hacksaw blade. There we go. We have ignition. The cotton ball ignites, and look at the way it burns. The cotton shrinks. The ball turns black as it leaves behind a carbon residue. You can see we got a good 25 to 30 seconds of burn time there with a regular cotton ball. Ooh, that flame right there looks cool. You can just see the heat rising from the charcoal ash. What we're left with now is basically black ash and burning residue, and that's got a lot of smoke coming off it. Look at all the smoke here. Look at all the smoke. So you can see that gives about 25 to 30 seconds of burn time. There's quite a bit of smoke, and the cotton ball doesn't completely burn unless you move it around and expose it to the oxygen. So now let's see how a regular cotton ball compares to nitro cotton. So this is test number one. It's the first cotton ball we soaked in acid yesterday, so theoretically it should be the most volatile. Here it is. Boom, there it goes. Man, okay, so do you see the difference in the burn time there? The flash cotton actually flashed. It went up in a huge ball of fire, and if you look down here at the residue, there's really not much ash left over. This is the original cotton ball that sat here burning for about 2 minutes before it finally died down to this ash, and there's still quite a bit of residue. Our flash cotton, you can see almost everything is gone. So cotton ball one was a success, and it went up very, very quickly, even though it was still in cotton ball form. If we would have stretched those fibers out, we could get them go off even faster. Watch this. So we don't have to burn the whole cotton ball at once. We can actually unroll it and give ourselves more material to work with, like so. What's really interesting is it still looks like cotton. It's still very fluffy. It still acts like cotton. It's just got a slightly yellowish tinge to it. Try ripping off a small piece of fiber like this and touch it gently with a flame and see just how quickly it goes off. Gone in a flash. That's why I love this stuff. It burns so quickly, it disappears before it even has a chance to hit the table. That's why they call it flash cotton, folks. Flash paper and flash cotton is the kind of stuff magicians use in their shows because it burns so quickly, it's very dramatic, and it doesn't leave any smoke or any ashy residue. And guys, if you flake off little pieces of your cotton ball like this, you can actually stretch one cotton ball to go an extremely long way. So there we have it, two tests down, two full successes. Now the purpose of this experiment today is really to see how many cotton balls we were able to nitrate with 80 milliliters of nitric acid. We took 8 cotton balls, soaked them each individually for 5 minutes, and my question is, at what point does the nitration start wearing off? So this may seem like a bit of a waste, but what we're gonna do now is burn through each of our cotton balls individually until we find the point where our flash cotton stops flashing. Bada boom.
Whoa,
it's almost explosive. Very volatile. Cotton ball number 6. A little bit slower. And there's a little bit more ashy residue there. Number 7. Still a good burn, but that was a lot slower, and you can see there's a lot more ash here as well. Down to our last cotton ball, this is number 8, and it's even got a nice little fuse sticking out of the top for us. Putting off a lot of interesting smoke there. Look at that, it's turning yellow. That's bizarre, it's burning extremely slowly. Lots of ash. It didn't ignite at all, it just kind of fizzled down, released a lot of yellow smoke, and turned into this black ash, which kind of has the smell of sulfuric acid. It left behind this tar-looking stuff as well. Crispy black ash, and a greasy tar residue. So interesting, guys. So out of 8 cotton balls, the first 5 of them went off perfectly, very, very quickly. It wasn't until the 6th cotton ball that we noticed a little bit of black ash residue, a little bit more than normal. The 7th burn was a little bit slower, and the 8th ball didn't even burn at all. It just released a ton of yellow smoke and melted down into this black ball of ash. So I think based on our experiment here today, we can safely conclude that 80 milliliters of nitric acid will fully nitrate between 5 to 6 cotton balls. Now we can actually look at the weights of our cotton balls and figure out exactly how much cotton that was. So just looking at our numbers here, it looks like the first 5 to 6 cotton balls comes out between about 3 grams to 3.25 grams. So my best guess based on this experiment is that 80 milliliters of nitric acid will successfully nitrate around 3 grams of cotton. And don't forget we nitrated a tampon as well, which is 2.4 grams. So theoretically, we should be able to get this to work. Now our little cotton tampon has a whole heck of a lot of cotton in it, so we could actually stretch it out to last quite a while. But I'm thinking, let's just light off this little strip here, and if it works, let's light off the whole thing, just because we can. Beauteous. Like magic. All right, so that worked, no problem at all. So let's go ahead and fluff this tampon out a bit and set it ablaze. There we go, beautiful. All right, here we go. Flash tampon in 3, 2, 1. Dang! That was a wicked fireball, and it just went up in my face. And it was in an instant, like less than a second, that entire tampon was completely burned. So we did it. The world's first pyrotechnic tampon. Cowbunga, dude. Dang! And look at this, there's hardly any ash at all. We've got like little tiny bits of black fiber, but the rest of it is completely gone. And no smoke. Did you see there was no smoke in that? Just a huge flash of fire. In fact, that was quite a bit higher than I was expecting. It whooped right up into my face. And look, there's hardly any ash residue at all. If you look down here, it's just a little bit of black matter, but for the most part, that tampon is gone in its entirety. So that was really cool, guys. And now based on these results, I think we can reach some conclusions from our experiments here today. We started off in yesterday's video taking regular cotton balls and soaking them in the solution of nitric and sulfuric acid. We rinsed the acid off, soaked it in baking soda water, and then rinsed it again and let them dry overnight to produce a batch of flash cotton. The purpose of today's experiment was to test those cotton balls to identify where the nitration started dropping off. And based on our results, we found that happened right around cotton ball number 6. Now because we used 80 milliliters of nitric acid to produce 6 cotton balls that went up in a flash, we determined that 1 milliliter of nitric acid nitrates about 0.04 grams of cotton. And because our cotton balls work so well, just for fun, we went ahead and nitrated a cotton feminine hygiene product to produce the world's first pyrotechnic tampon. So there we have it, guys. We now know how to use nitric and sulfuric acids to produce flash cotton. Whoa. Thanks for joining me for this experiment. I'll be looking for you in the next one. Talk to you then. All right, here we go. Shower of sparks in 3, 2, 1. And I missed. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, tampon. Ha ha ha.